Today, I want to talk about the difference between business goals and coaching goals. Of course, an effective coaching goal in a professional setting is going to have a positive impact and positive outcomes for the business. But I often work with leaders who have trouble creating that coaching goal and understanding the difference. We're all familiar with business goals. A business goal might be to hit a certain revenue target, finish a project on time. Sometimes I even run into leaders who have a business goal that says they want to create a high performing or a higher performing team. So then what is a coaching goal? A coaching goal is about how you're going to accomplish these things. It's about the behaviors that are required to successfully meet and exceed those goals. It's also often about a leader working on a skill that they've struggled with in the past, or possibly working on a new skill that they need to be effective in their role today that maybe wasn't required of them in the past. So, what are a couple of examples? Let's take that high-performing team goal. First, we need to know what are the measures, what does this look like, and how are we going to know if we've been successful and made progress against this goal of creating a high-performing team? What I want to understand from the leader is where their strengths are, what are they already doing today to foster that high performance, and then also what are they struggling with or what is new to them that they think they need to enact in order to meet this goal. It could be anything. I've had leaders who say, I need to delegate more. I'm so used to doing everything myself that I know I keep too much. It's burning me out. It's also preventing my team from growing and developing themselves. So that would be a really great example of a coaching goal. We would work with that leader to delegate more, to delegate effectively, and we could measure that at the end of our time together pretty easily. Another effective coaching goal might be something like speaking up more on behalf of myself and my team in leadership meetings. I work with even some very senior executives who are either intimidated in large meetings where a lot of senior leaders are present, or they might just feel there are so many voices in that room. I don't know if it really is necessary or it matters to add mine. And yet they know, or they're hearing, or they're getting feedback that says you actually have to show up and express yourself in those meetings. Why? People need to get to know you. Also, you have smart and great ideas. That's why you're there. We want you to contribute those. And also, sometimes in that kind of a meeting, you want to advocate for your team or set the stage for something your team is doing so those other senior leaders and stakeholders can then be in support of your team as your team works toward its goals. So again, we're going to understand first what is the motivation, what is the struggle that this leader is having speaking up in that large forum, and then start practicing and experimenting. Can you say just one thing? Can you catch yourself self-censoring when you had a comment, but then you started doubting yourself and thinking, well, I shouldn't say that. Somebody already said that, or nobody cares, et cetera. So to achieve these goals, we work on really small experiments that help start to recognize the behaviors that are getting in the way, and then based on that, start creating some new behaviors. I hope that this is making sense, that typically a business goal is an accomplishment, an achievement, meeting a certain objective, and typically a coaching goal is about changing or adapting a behavior, possibly creating a new behavior that's going to serve you that maybe you simply haven't had experience with in the past.